Hello, this is Tola from Trasfer Productions with another Blender quick tip. In this quick tip, I'm going to show you how you can transfer the movement from one character to the next without having to go through a tedious process of using the LA editor in order to get that done. And what I mean is this. Let's play this animation here. You can tell she's clapping and she's about to talk to someone. There she goes. Let's stop that and rewind. Okay, let's open up the NLA editor. And this is Blender 2.79. And in 2.79, what you had to do was just pretty much a tedious process. It was just something that was just cumbersome. Copying actions and pasting them into this joint action deal, and it was just something else. And then 2.7 and 2.8, actually, it's a lot easier. Where you don't have to use the NLA editor at all. And what makes the difference, is the fact that in 2.79, you had these little slits that indicated the... I think these were supposed to be the keyframes for your animation. And those were kind of hard to select, kind of hard to pinpoint when you wanted to make some kind of adjustment. You'd have to pretty much go into the dope sheet and make your selections there. And if you had a lot of characters lined up there, it would slow down your user interface quite a bit. But let's close that out and open up 2.8. It's like the weather is cold out here, so a lot of phlegm and things in my throat, so... Pardon me for clearing my throat into the mic. I apologize for that. But this character, the same setup, she's clapping and she's talking to someone. We want to actually transfer her movement to her movement. Now, in 2.8, they've done a great job of putting those diamond-shaped keyframes into the timelines as opposed to those slits that weren't helpful at all. And what you want to do is you want to click on this character. Let's make her... keyframes a little bit smaller. They already are small. I recorded this tutorial like 10 times, so that's why I've made the corrections beforehand. But you can tell her keyframes have been highlighted because they're all yellow. If they're white like this and they're not highlighted, what you want to do is press A, have your mouse hovered over the keyframes or the timeline, and press A, and they'll all be highlighted. That means they're all active. And what you want to do is press Control C, because you're copying it to the buffer. And then you're going to select your second character. Apparently you can see that her keyframes have not been highlighted, that's why they're all white, so press A. And press G to grab and drag them over, which is very important. I'll explain why in a minute. And then we're going to press Control V. And then once we've done that, you can see that she's now posing the same way that she is when we played back. They're both talking, doing the exact same movement. And that is a whole lot faster than doing it in 2.79. We have to use the NLA editor to transfer an action from one character to the next. So we're going to stop that. Now I'm going to explain why I took the first character's keyframes, and limped off to the side. Now whenever you set up keyframes in Blender, it creates an F-curve. Once the keyframes are gone, the F-curve is gone. And if you try to paste the keyframes from one character to the next that doesn't have an F-curve, it's going to bring up a warning saying that there's no F-curve present to paste the keyframes to. And I'll give an example of that. Let's press X to delete those keyframes. And we're going to press A again to highlight those and press X. Okay. We're going to go back to this character again and press Control-C. Go back to this character and press Control V, the warning, no F curve to paste to. So it's important that when this character's actions, you want to remove them, just slide her keyframes off of the timeline and paste the keyframes from this character onto the timeline, and that will eliminate that warning. But that's today's Blender quick tip. I'm thankful that I got through it, because like I explained before, this is like the 10th time I had to do this tutorial. It's kind of strange how when you want to do a recording, all of a sudden everyone's calling at the same time, your phone just going off the hinges, which is what happens to me. So this is today's tutorial. I hope it helps someone. And I hope you guys have a great evening, have a great night, and see you on the next one. All right, adios.